you are properly focusing on the major players there, the regulators, the Fed in particular, the investment banks. And, you know, as anybody watching the shows knows, I've gone after those investment banks. I want to focus for a minute on the Fed. You talked about the Fed. That was run out of Washington by Alan Greenspan, here in New York by Tim Geithner, who's now the Treasury Secretary. If I hear what you're saying they had the tools to stop what happened.
Absolutely. Let me just give you one example. The Federal Reserve was the one entity that had the full authority to set mortgage lending standards in this country. And starting in the late 1990s, they started to get widespread reports of egregious predatory lending practices. As you know, many attorney generals jumped into the fight in the early 2000s to stop unfair lending, pernicious lending practices, and the Fed stopped them from doing that. So the Federal Reserve, it was pushed by its staff. It adopted some rules in 2001 to control out-of-control subprime lending. They thought the rules would affect 38% of the loans. It only affected 1%. It's not until 2006 that they even put down voluntary guidance, and not until July 2008 that they actually adopt a rule saying you can't make a loan to a person who can't afford to pay that loan. But, Elliot, here's even what I think is more disturbing. When we questioned Alan Greenspan about this, he said, well, you didn't need more regulation. What you needed was stronger law enforcement. So we went and looked at the records. And as it turned out, the Federal Reserve, in the midst of all this terrible lending, from 2000 to 2006 under Mr. Greenspan, referred a whopping 3 unfair lending cases to the Department of Justice. A little bank in Carpentersville, Illinois, a little bank in Victorville, California, and the New York branch of Societe Generale. Nothing.
Look, as anybody who's watched this knows, I was an AG back then. They tried to shut us down when we tried to enforce the law. They didn't try to come in on our side. The tougher question that I think we need to discuss now is we've pretty well got our arms around what happened when we look backwards. The question is, have we learned the lesson? Have you seen recently what Alan Greenspan has been saying about the effort to impose some rules on the financial services sector? What has he been saying, and can we make any sense out of it?
Well, he's saying a couple of things. He's saying, first of all, the reason we have a slow economic recovery is too much government activism, and he's decried the frenetic pace of new financial regulation. He recently said that the invisible hand, you know, the Adam Smith, the free markets, let the markets do what they want, has worked well with rare exceptions. Of course, that rare exception being 27 million people out of work. I mean, there's an active effort here to rewrite history. And the fact is, this was the guy, Alan Greenspan, who had his hand on the steering wheels. He had his foot on the gas pedal as we were driven over the cliff. And now he wants to give us driving lessons. But Elliot, in the course of our inquiry, I saw very little self-reflection on Wall Street, I think in no small part due to the fact that the American taxpayers, yes.
If time is running out, I got one question to you. You and I both know for years the whole mantra on Wall Street was self-regulation. We will regulate ourselves. I think it was bunk and gibberish and never worked. Did you ever see any evidence that anybody on Wall Street picked up the phone, you got to give me a 10-second answer on this, ever picked up the phone and called the Fed, the OCC, the OTS, any regulator, and said, we got a crisis coming? Or did they merely, as you say, put their foot on the pedal and lend, and take us right over that cliff?
Well, the industry as a whole, lend, take us over the cliff. There were some individuals who tried to speak up, but they were dwarfed by the sheer momentum of the big financial institutions who drove us towards this crisis.